In this video, you'll see how to export and import your shop data, including your store metafields. So in the Excelify app, I'll go to new export, and out of those all things, you can see here's a new kind of tab which says shop. So I select to export the shop. And I can include or not include the other details, because it's the like the attributes like email and owner of the store. But let's include it and see what's there. And also, of course, I include metafields so that you can work with them, because you can import metafields as well, while these other details are export only. So here I choose the format to export to Excel, which is the most convenient way, and press export. Wait a couple of seconds, and that's it. So I download the exported file, and here's what I have here. So I have the sheet named shop, which indicates that this is the shop data. Here I see the shop domain, I have the name of the Shopify store, the created ad and updated ad. Those lighter green columns, they are like the basic columns. Still you can't change them, but they will be always included. And those darker green are those additional details like the domain, the owner, the email, and so on. And there's a lots of them. You can see their description in our website. But today's topic here is about the metafields. So at the end you see there's like this one metafield, let's say Shopify POS attributes with the JSON in it. And the same way we can add or delete any kind of metafields, which I'll show you how to do. Basically we can just delete all those other columns as we don't need them, and we can't change them anyway. And the same way we can basically copy this column name and create a new metafield. So the same as anything in Excelify with metafields, the column name must start with metafield column, and then comes the, maybe here it's better visible, here comes the namespace, then is a dot, and then there is a key of the metafield, and then in the square brackets it's a type of the metafield. It can be string, JSON string, or integer, which is a number. So just for example, we'll create, like in the Excelify namespace, we'll create translations, which will be a JSON string, and we can use those translations in the on our website. For example, we can write that here is the translation. Let me just make it bigger. So it will be the JSON with the values like English, French, for example. It will be hello and French word for hello. And that's it. And for this metafield, we'll just, let's just remove it from the file. It means that we will not change it. But if we will, if we would import it like this, the Excelify would delete this metafield from your store. So there's a difference, and decide what you want to do. If you want to delete this metafield, then you just import it with an empty value here. If you want it to stay as it is in your Shopify store, then you just remove it from the file. You don't import it, so it will not get changed. And just for the sake of example, import one more, like some kind of number, which is an integer. Here would be like 1, 2, 3. Let's say you want to save some number. And by the way, if you don't specify the type of the of this meta field, the Excelify will try to guess the type. For example, if it will see it as a number, it will automatically assume it's an integer. And it, if it will see the text here, so it will assume it's a string. And if it will see a valid JSON without specifying the type, it will assume it's a JSON string. So essentially, you could just not use them. But if you want to be precise, of course, then please do use. Okay, and so I am saving the file, shop meta fields. Remember that the sheet name should be shop, exactly like this down below. And then the Excelify will know that, okay, you are importing the shop data. Now I'm going back to the Excelify app, and in the import section, I just click and choose this file. Then we can validate that, okay, Excelify has found a shop sheet with one entry in it. Of course, it can have just one because you have one shop. And then there is the unknown sheet export summary, which is ignored, of course. There are some options, but basically we press import. And okay, it has imported and it says that it's updated one shop. We can download import results and see that indeed it was import result okay, and comment is update. And if it if we had an error here, then it would say what kind of error it is. And so yeah, we can check if this has imported correctly by going again to export and exporting. And since it's always exporting from the Shopify database, we don't store this data anywhere else besides the Shopify database, so you will always have the most recent exported data. So we open the file, and you indeed you can see that all those three meta fields are here. And for example, if I want to delete them, I can remember, I can just clear the value here again, import the new file. Was it the export, this one? Press import, wait a couple of seconds, download import results, and and yeah, it's you see in the comment it says metafield number deleted, so it's not existing anymore in your in your store. Well, yeah, this is how you import, export, and update your Shopify store metafields. See you around.